Belmez de Moraleda is a Spanish town located north of Andalusia. It is in the village completely common in appearance, but in which there has been one of the strangest and most inexplicable phenomena of our time. The faces of Belmez, these appear without anyone knowing what they are or who has done them. To this day, nobody has been able to find an explanation. On August 23, 1971, on the street named Rodriguez Acosta No. 5, there lived Maria Pereira. As usual, she was about to prepare the family meal. But that day Maria was not prepared to what was going to witness. According to Maria, I was preparing the food when I noticed a stain on the ground, but the more I looked at the stain, the greater the impression of seeing a face appear. I thought I was sick, with a fever or something, so I told my neighbors to come and see. The neighbors went to Maria's call and were just as stunned as Maria. No one could understand what was happening. We came to see what Maria was telling us, we wanted to verify what she told us, but we discovered a horrible spectacle. Another neighbor says. We were very afraid. Faces appeared and disappeared on the floor, we did not know why this was happening, one face, and then another, no one understood anything, I was terrified. After the event, Maria did not understand what was happening, but she did not want to understand it either. All she wanted was to make those spots disappear and the phenomena to stop happening. I tried to remove the faces with detergent. I wanted to forget what I had been through. But, even if the traces left, they would reappear somewhere else soon after. This phenomenon begins to disturb the Pereira family. To put an end to these strange spots forever, Miguel, Maria's son, decides to totally redo the kitchen floor. But soon another face embedded in the ground appeared again. The news quickly spreads and takes on a national dimension. The house of the Pereira was assaulted by a curious crowd, intrigued by this supernatural manifestation. Desperate, Maria goes to the governor of the province that summons scientists and parapsychologists. A major research was conducted by the Superior Council of Scientific Investigations with German de Argumosa as head investigator of parapsychologist based in Madrid. They decided to seal the room to show that there was no human manipulation on the faces. Researchers photographed and mapped the floor of the house before covering it with cloth and sealing it with wax to avoid tampering. The floor was divided into pictures that corresponded to the images, which were numbered and photographed for later comparison. And a new kitchen was built in another corner of the house for the family. In order to give it a more serious character, the notary Antonio Palacios Luque was hired, who proceeded to seal the room before the German television cameras. Another famous parapsychologist also participated, Dr. Hans Bender, professor at the University of Freiburg and friend of Fermín de Argumosa. An interesting fact is that the German researcher Hans Bender declared that the faces of Belmez was the most important paranormal phenomenon of the 20th century. The sealing process was for 3 months. The floor of the kitchen is redone, and they closed the room for 3 months, with the doors and windows sealed so that no one can enter. 3 months later they opened the kitchen again and what they found shocked them. 17 new faces had appeared. The scientists tried to find a reasonable explanation, but they found nothing that could explain it. The faces were appearing from under the cement. Then, they began digging 3 meters deep, and they made a shocking discovery. The house had been built on a 13th century cemetery. Bones of decapitated teen children appear there. There are even pictures of people who were tortured in that house during the Civil War. Two parapsychologists did an acoustic test, and their conclusion was disturbing. They recorded screams, complaints, laments, they recorded strange voices with clearly distinguishable words and with sounds like trumpets and others. In some of the first psychophonies they recorded voices that said, "Poor Kiko," or spoke of a lupanar. At first it was thought that in that house, before Maria Gomez was born, there had been a fight in which a character named Kiko participated. Other psychophonies voices apparently said, "Hell starts here." There were other voices that say, "Did I emerged, or am still buried?" Another voice said, "Who comes here will be reborn." When one of the researchers stated that they might be beings from beyond this world, one of the voices replied, "Souls exist." Or a more current one that said, "Kill him." Also in that process the word FE, which means faith, appeared under the fireplace. It is thought that the faces would try to establish a contact with Maria Pereira since the expressions of the faces seem tied to the feelings of Maria. It is what is called teleplasty. Maria died on February 3, 2004 at the age of 85. This woman was perhaps the only person who had the answer to what will forever be a mystery.